Hey everybody, great to see you back. In my last video, I explained about presence detection in Home Assistant, so that devices switch in your house based on if somebody is at home or not at home. Thank you for all the comments and likes on that video, and I would like to thank Richard van der Pol especially for his suggestion for a new video, which is about geofencing in Home Assistant. That's actually a great idea. So here you have it. This video is about switching devices in your house if somebody enters or leaves a zone around your house. So, here we are. I'm going to show you how you can set up geofencing in Home Assistant. You might be aware that there are some suppliers that deliver heating devices that switch if somebody leaves or enters a zone around the house. And we're going to build this exactly the same in Home Assistant. But first, let me show you some use cases. So this is your house, and your house is situated somewhere in a city, let's say the center of Amsterdam. Around the house, you're going to define an area, and you want your house to switch based on if people enter or exit that area. So let's go for the first use case. Nobody is within the area, so the heating of your house is set to low. Now one person enters the area and you want to heat up your house already, so the heating is set to high as soon as this person enters the area. Now another person is entering the area and the heating should stay high because that person is also a member of your family. So they're both at home and it's really cozy at home because the temperature is high. Now one person is leaving the area, but the temperatures should still be high in your house, so the heating stays high. And now the other person is leaving the area and then the heating should be set to low. Now let's go over to Home Assistant to see how you can set this up. One of the things that you first have to do is to make sure that you have the Home Assistant Companion app installed on your phone, because the Home Assistant Companion app can determine where you are exactly on the planet, and that is needed to determine if you are in the area that you defined or that you are outside the area that you defined. So make sure that you got that installed on your phone. But I think you already got that because you use that to control your whole Home Assistant system. Next to installing the Home Assistant Companion app on your phone, you have to make sure that location services are enabled on your phone for the Home Assistant app. Because without that, the phone cannot determine where you are on the planet. So make sure you do that. It's different for iPhone or Android, but you might find it somewhere in settings, privacy, location services, somewhere like that. Make sure that that works. Now you set up your phone correctly, we're going to Home Assistant to set up the rest of the things. First, we go to People, and you can find that by going to Configuration, People and Zones, and then you'll probably see the people in your house already here. You can open every one of them and change things here, like the picture and all that stuff. But what the most important thing is that you have to make sure that your device trackers are being connected to that person, and that is this space in the person entity. So you can choose tracking devices here. I already got my iPhone chosen here. So if I show you this and I open it, and you see here there's a device tracker iPhone XS. Make sure that this icon is in front of it, because this icon shows you that it's about the device tracker of your phone. I have other device trackers too. For instance, this device tracker is one that is in my router. But for now, we are going to focus on the device tracker on your phone, because that actually sends the GPS data that is needed to see whether you are entering a zone or that you are leaving a zone. So make sure that for every person in your house, you select the correct tracking device. So what I did, I did it for myself and I did it for my girlfriend. I also had the tracking device of my girlfriend selected here. Here it is, and that is also the phone of my girlfriend. Okay, So now we got that set up. It means that I have two persons now that I can track within a zone. Now I'm going to set up the zone around my house. For that, we have to edit the configuration.yaml. And to edit the configuration.yaml, you need a file editor. There are several file editors in Home Assistant. For instance, you have the file editor and you have the studio code server. If you didn't install those yet, you can go to configuration, add-ons, backups, and supervisor. And within this add-ons tab, you can go to add-on store and you can search here for the file editor, or you can search for the studio code server. Both will work. Studio code server needs a bit of a stronger machine to run Home Assistant on, but both work. So make sure that you either install file editor or studio code server. I prefer to use studio code server, so I'm opening studio code server now. And studio code server shows you all the files and folders of your Home Assistant installation. And what we are going to edit now is the configuration.yaml file, which is here. I added these lines. These are the lines you need to install or activate the proximity integration into Home Assistant. So what is this saying? You start with the name proximity, which is the name of the integration. Then you give your area a name. Let's say in this case, home. And within home, you are going to assign some devices to it. And in this case, it is person.at and person.ariet, which are the two persons that I showed you in the step before this. Then you can enter a tolerance, and the tolerance is in meters. And then you can enter a unit of measurement. In my case, it's kilometers, but you can also use other values there, like miles, for example. And this is basically everything what you have to do. Then you save the configuration.yaml, and every time when you save a configuration.yaml, you have to reboot Home Assistant. So for that, you go to configuration, settings, then you can click check configuration. If you don't see all this, by the way, that means that you don't have the advanced mode enabled in Home Assistant. You can enable the advanced mode in your profile. Now, let's click check configuration, see if configuration is valid, and it's valid, and then I click on restart and it restarts Home Assistant. I already did that, so I'm not going to reboot, but you have to do that, otherwise the proximity sensor will not be available for you. Okay, let's check our proximity sensor if it works. So for that, I'm going to developer tools, and I'm going to click set state, entity, and I'm going to type proximity, and there it is, proximity.home. I'm opening this, and you see the state is at this moment zero, and that means that I am at home, or at least somebody is at home. Basically, the state shows the kilometers or miles or whatever that you are away from your home. So you see that zero of travel is arrived, and that the nearest are me and my girlfriend, and that is because we are home. So that is okay. What happens if we are leaving the home is that the state is going to change. So if we are away for 1 kilometer from our home, then the state will be set to 1. And if we are from 2 kilometers from our home, the state will be set to 2, etc. The other thing is that if one of us stays at home, the state will stay 0. So it can be that I am like 5 kilometers away from my home, but my girlfriend is at home, then the states will still be 0 because there is somebody at home. Great, the proximity sensor is working. Now we are going to set up the automations to switch the heating. So for the automations, we go to configuration, automation and scenes, and we're going to create a new automation by clicking on create automation. We are not going to select a blueprint, but we are going to start with an empty automation here. And I'm going to give this automation a name. Let's say Geofence switch heating. And now we are going to set up the triggers. For the trigger type, I'm going to choose the numeric state trigger type. And for entity, I'm going to select our proximity sensor, proximity home. And I'm going to say, if we are further away than, let's say, 5 kilometers, then we have to do something. I'm going to give this proximity sensor a trigger ID. So let's say leaving home. That is the trigger ID. Now I'm going to create another trigger, which is about approaching home. So I'm going to add another trigger here. I'm going to select numeric state again, entity, proximity, home. And I'm going to say, if we are below 5 kilometers, and I'm giving it a trigger ID, approaching home. So I have two triggers now. One trigger that triggers if I'm further away than 5 kilometers around my home. And I created another trigger that is going to trigger when I am within that area. So when it's below 5 kilometers. Now we are going to actions. For this, first we are going to create a choose action. And this is all about trigger IDs. If you don't know how trigger IDs work, I have a video about it. And check that video first, then you know how that works. But I'm going to apply it here. So I'm going to add a choose type. And within the choose type, I'm going to add a condition. And the condition in this case is triggered by. I'm going to say, which trigger is that? Okay, let's say leaving home. This is the trigger ID that I defined it on top of this automation. And then I'm going to say, if we are leaving our home, I'm going to add an action. Let's make it a service. And the service is climate.setTemperature. You can choose other services if you like, but I'm using this now. I'm going to say, choose entity. Let's say the climate of our living room. You can also select every room in your house, of course. I'm going to say the temperature is going to be 15 degrees when I'm leaving home. Now I'm going to add another option. And that within that option, we have a condition again. The condition type is triggered by. And now we are going to say approaching home. So as soon as somebody enters the area of 5 kilometers around my home, I'm going to add an action. Let's call a service again. Let's call that service climate.setTemperature. Choose entity. Again, I'm going to choose the living room and I'm going to set the temperature to, let's say, 21 degrees. Save it, and we go over it once again to explain it really clearly. So what do we have here? We have a title. We have two triggers. One trigger that triggers when you are away more than 5 kilometers from your home, and another trigger that triggers when you are within 5 kilometers of your home. And then action, if the trigger leaving home is triggered, then set the temperature to 15 degrees. And if the trigger approaching home is triggered, then set the temperature to 21 degrees. What you can do to check it is add another thing. So I'm going to add another action that sends a message to my phone that the temperature is set to 15 degrees here. So I'm going to add action here. And I'm going to say service, notify, let's say notify to my phone. I want to have a message. The temperature is set to 15 degrees Celsius in our case. Title, you left your house. And for option two, I'm also creating an other action. Again, call service, notify, notification to my phone. Message is the temperature is set to 21 degrees. And the title is You Are Approaching Your House. Save it. So now I will also get a message about what happens when I'm entering or leaving the zone that I defined. And that is basically everything that you have to do to set this up. So I hope it helped. If so, give the video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, tick the little bell, and please leave a comment. I really would like that. Thank you and bye bye.